Hello folks, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here. In today's video, I'm going to be passing over to Jackson Hayes. Now Jackson, I've known him for a fairly long time now, about 2 years or so. He's a student and he's also very proactive as a student and goes above and beyond. He creates a YouTube channel as well, where he does fantastic cinematography and also does video reviews for a very big tech publication. And as you can imagine, he uses lots of apps across his day, particularly Trello, Things3, and Google Calendar. Today's video is going to be all about that. So he's going to be taking us through how he uses that. But I just wanted to say big thank you to Jackson, and everyone should go and subscribe to his fantastic, really well put together videos, not like mine. So go and subscribe to him and enjoy this feature from Jackson. I'll talk to you guys very soon, and thank you, Jackson.
Hi there, my name is Jackson Hayes. I'm a cinematographer, YouTuber, full-time student, and managing all that is quite a lot. So Francesco asked me to kind of talk about my productivity system, how I manage everything, and kind of break all of that down for y'all. You can kind of think of it as a three-pronged approach, with Google Calendar being the main overarching kind of management system, Trello as our more like project-based management, and then Things as like various individual tasks. All right, so now we're gonna jump into the computer and kind of see how everything is going down. Right now, I've pulled up a calendar a week from a few weeks ago while I was actually in school. Right now, I'm on break, and that's why I have time to make YouTube videos. But this kind of is a really good picture of how I managed everything. So some things are redacted, maybe. I don't know, I might redact some things. We'll see. Basically, I break everything down into individual calendars. I like being able to separate my school calendar events from my personal calendar events from my work calendar events. So I've got personal, classes, client, family, film, Lux, which is one of the companies I work for, which is kind of separate from client, even though they are a client. I've got podcasting, school, and then YouTube. Now, some of these calendars I don't actually use actively just because, well, I haven't podcasted in a while. Family events, being living away from my family, I never really used that calendar. I'm going to be using it more now that I'm back home. Some of these I'm not using. I might rework some of this, but this is the basic idea. I've got multiple calendars for different types of calendar events. Now, obviously, my school calendar events, those would be recurring. They would have things like where the class was going to be meeting, what time, obviously, because that's a calendar event, as well as contact information for the individual instructors, just in case something were to come up. And so these events would just repeat until the end of the semester, so I would always have those in there, wouldn't have to create those individually. Repeating calendar events are so helpful. And then I would kind of fill up my schedule kind of based around that. Given that I'm a freelancer and I work remotely, I'm able to kind of build my schedule how I want it. And so you can see here I've got this like work event, and this is just for Lux. I would be doing like customer support and web development and things like that. So I would just build out different little calendar events of like windows of time that I would have where I could get some work done. I'd also put in, you know, giant blocks of time to do homework because I have to pass. That's how I'd kind of structure that. And then I'd also have like personal events, different things I had to do, haircuts, things like that. That would just kind of build out the schedule from there. And so I would pretty much go through and just schedule the next day's events just in case something were to come up. I'd be able to kind of react fast enough. If I were to go ahead and like filled out my entire week, you know, things change and things happen, so like I like just building out the next day. So this would progressively fill out as the week went on, but that's kind of my basic calendar. It changes a little bit when it's, you know, winter break. Now I'm doing a lot more work, no school because I'm done for the semester. And so yeah, that's kind of how that is built out. All right, so now let's jump into Trello. Trello is how I manage my projects. Lately, it's been just for school and homework. I do have these other things. I have like a board I'm on for Android Police, and that's one of the videos that I do for this company called Android Police, where I make videos for their channel about Android. And that's how we manage our projects there. I'm not gonna really open that because I don't think I am necessarily allowed to show that in this video. But my main board is college. And so I have it in all caps because I'm weird like that. And I would have different lists per day. the way I built this out is, you know, per day I have what I have to do. And so on Sundays, I would go through the syllabus or whatever was due that week and build that out into individual cards. And I throw them all into Monday, and then I would schedule them and move them how I wanted. So let's pretend I'm still in school, which I'm not, because it's a break, but let's pretend I am. And say I had something due for my English class, okay? So let's say, write. Now I would put it in all caps just because, I don't know, it felt like a good system. So I'd do write. Let's say it's, research report. Now, if it's a big project, like it's, so for my English class, we had four major projects. If it's a major project, I would create a checklist. So it's like, you know, outline or research outline, write the first draft, edit, things like that. So let's just pretend to do that real quick. So we can go research spelling outline, first draft, edit, and then submit, right? Now, I would have labels for each different class. So let's say English 101. And then I would label whether it was going to be a quick little task to do that I could get out of the way very quickly, a medium, like, it will take a little while, but not too long, or long. And then, like, this would be like a first draft. If I have to write the entire draft, that would be a long project. But let's just say it's medium because it's just research and outline. Those are the first things. And then I would put the due date in. Now, sometimes I would put a due date like a few days before just so I would, like, you know, finish things on the earlier side. That can get dangerous though, because it's like if you forget that the day you put in was actually the due date and you think, oh, I have 2 days because you normally put 2 days in, then you might have a late project and you don't want to do that. And so if I were to say, like, put the due date 2 days before, I would also write the actual due date here in this description. But yeah, let's just pretend this is due on Monday because the teacher was not being nice and, you know, gave me something to do over the weekend. And that's how I'd have that. And let's pretend it's Sunday, right? So we're going through and putting something for the entire week. And I would go through every single class and put in all the homework and all the things I had to read or whatever. I'd put that all in. And then I would just kind of move it around to when I wanted to do it. Say it's due on Monday, right? I would probably put that on a Thursday so I could finish it by Friday and not have to submit, you know, work over the weekend. Oftentimes I would end up working on the weekend, but I would always try to not, because who likes that? And so that's how I would manage everything. And I would fill this out. There'd be like tons and tons of cards. Some days, you know, they'd be pretty easy. Some days, you know, it's a lot of stuff. But being able to see everything that I had to do for all my classes in one place was extremely helpful. Not having to go to, you know, the school website and try to, you know, go into each different class and figure out what's due now. Doing that all at once on a Sunday, having that all done for the entire week was just life-changing. I'm sorry, I'm just very excited about this. It helped me so much. Now, the way I would approach, like, my homework, in case you guys are wondering, I would pretty much do the easier tasks first and then the harder tasks later. Because if I have a giant list and I'm working on something for hours and it's, like, the harder project, then after that I have a few, like, quick and medium projects, it would just get discouraging because I'd finish one thing, I felt like I did a lot, but I'd still have a ton to do. So I typically go from easy to hard, you know, that kind of snowball effect. That's just the way I work. You don't have to do that at all, of course, but that's how I would do things. So yeah, this is how I kind of lay things out. I'd also have like weekend and future. If there was a big project that was kind of like looming that I wanted to kind of like have in my mind, I would throw that into the future. If there's something to do on the weekend, I put that on weekend. And often, if it's a Saturday night, I would move weekend over to the very beginning, like all the way over to before Monday so that I would see that first instead of having to scroll over. But yeah, that's how I'd manage everything, and it really, really helped. So now jumping into things where I manage my like smaller tasks and less school-related stuff, because that's what I would do in Trello. I wouldn't really do much YouTube management there. I sometimes do, but it's not the best system yet, so I'm still working on that. And it doesn't really fit in Google Calendar because I don't put tasks in calendars. That just doesn't make sense to me. And so I do it all in things. So this is where I pretty much break down like my client work. I don't really do that in Trello. While I totally could and, you know, use checklists for each project or whatever, it just doesn't really work for me, and I really like the design of things. Now, I do use Todoist. I used to use Todoist, and I also used to use things, and I would go back and forth. I would switch like every couple of months. It's not a good idea. It's just a lot of time, especially going from things back to Todoist, because there's no import method. Like, you can do that. Like, if you're on Todoist and you want to go to things, they have an import tool, and it's amazing. But there's no way to go back, so you have to like just input everything manually, and it's a pain in the butt. I would still do it. Not recommended. So right now I'm on things. Todoist is great too. I love Todoist. but right now Things is kind of where I'm managing everything. So as you can see here, I've got quite a lot of like projects and things like that. In Things, there's something called Areas, which is like kind of a folder you can put projects into. And so I've got personal, YouTube, Lux Optics, clients, film, photography, design, school, and templates. I have Lux Optics separate from clients because since they're such a big client and they often have a lot of different projects going on, so I don't want to have that all kind of jumbled up inside of clients. Because my other clients, it's kind of like one-time things that like happen kind of slowly, so it's not like as big of a deal. And so that's why I have that kind of separated there. One thing you might notice, at the very top, I have winter break. And whenever I have a trip I'm going on or some big event that's happening, I like to have all the tasks that I'm doing in a project that's like at the very, very top, because that's the kind of like the biggest thing that's on my mind. So if there's things I have to do while I'm on winter break or on a trip or whatever, I put that in there and I kind of have that separated. Going down the list, I've got personal. So this is kind of just, you know, personal stuff. I got Marine Corps because I'm in the process of joining the Marine Corps, which some of you might know if you know me, some of you might not if you know me, but yeah, that's happening. Life management. I don't know why that's a project. Okay, whatever, that was random. I deleted it. It was a holdover from something a while ago. It's not important. I don't use that anymore. Anyway, I've got my personal website, which I'm trying to build. It's taking a while because I just never have time. I've got finance, health. Sequence is an app I'm working on that's taking a while because I'm waiting for a certain language to be more stable before I write it. Anyway, below that, I've got YouTube. So keep productive. That's this video that I'm, you know, keeping track of what I need to do. I've got a review of a phone coming up. And then, you know, it's just kind of standard going down the list. I've got templates. Things doesn't really have a very specific like template function, but you can duplicate a project. So I've just been using that to like manage YouTube video tasks because it's pretty standard. Like I have to outline a video, I have to script it out, I have to record the voiceover, or if it's just a talking head, I'll just outline it and then just do it. But yeah, I just have a lot of tasks I need to remember to do. And so I have these templates in there and it's super, super handy. You can kind of take a look here. I've got these headers, so it's outline video, shoot A-roll, edit a clean cut, so it's like a finalized video, but it's just A-roll. After that, I'll shot list my YouTube B-roll, I'll film the B-roll, I'll edit it in, color grade, verify audio is at about -3 dB, decibels, add the music, make the thumbnail, upload the video, write the description, add tags, schedule for production, and prep social media posts. So it's quite a lot, but it's helpful to have kind of a template to be able to reuse over and over and make sure that you hit various things. Like, having the audio way too quiet is really annoying, and it's always annoying when you forget it and you're like, oh, well, sorry about that. So just having things like that is very, very helpful for me. So then one last little thing that I like about Things is, is that you can see your calendar inside the app. So having that integration is really, really nice because you can see kind of everything that's going on in the day and also all your tasks. So that's super helpful for me and I really, really like it. Well, that's pretty much my system, from Google Calendar to Trello to Things. Hopefully that made sense. Hopefully you got something out of it, maybe something you can adapt to your own workflow. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me. I'm Jackson H Visuals on Twitter and Instagram, so feel free to DM me and ask any questions you might have. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Well, huge thanks to Francesco for having me on his channel. I've wanted to talk about my productivity setup for a while, but my own YouTube channel doesn't really fit that kind of content. And so this was a great way to kind of have an outlet to talk about this. So yeah, huge thanks to Francesco. Huge thanks to you guys for watching. And yeah, this is Jackson Hayes signing off.